Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at setting up body motion capture with the Motion Live 2D plugin for Cartoon Animator 4 using the Perception Neuron body mocap suit. By the end of this tutorial, you'll be familiar with the complete setup process as well as some important settings in Cartoon Animator. Let's talk about connecting and previewing first. Here you can see we have some raw data streaming from Perception Neuron. In this sample, we're using Axis Neuron Pro. The first thing we want to do to be able to stream this data into Cartoon Animator is to open the Motion Live 2D plugin from the plugin menu at the top. You also have an option to open it from the toolbar as well. Here you'll see a number of different gear profiles for the body, hands, and face. Since we're using Perception Neuron at this time, let's select the empty red circle beside our device for both the body and the hands. This will ensure that the device is connected and streaming data into Cartoon Animator. Next, you'll want to get to your character list and select which character will use the device for the body and hands. Again, we'll select Perception Neuron for both. We also need to switch both hands in order to get the right control setting. This is because the default control setting is suitable for leap motion. Then we can click the preview button and press the space key to activate the preview, and we'll see our results. The next important part about setting up your mocap is setting the correct T-pose so that your character skeleton in Cartoon Animator has a reference pose to use when streaming the mocap data in. Once you're in the proper T-pose in your Noitum window, you'll want to select Set T-pose in Cartoon Animator. Once we do that, we can bring our arms down and see the correct result for our character's arms. If your arms are too low when you set the T-pose, you'll get results like this, where even though your actor's arms are by their side, the on-screen character's arms will still be slightly floating. This is because it is using an incorrect arm position for the T-pose. The opposite is true if your actor's arms are too high when setting the T-pose. If this is the case, your character's arms will go lower than your actor's, due to the incorrect reference pose. Let's take a look next at the animation profile and offset settings. You can see on the right that there are a number of different profiles depending on which direction your character is facing on screen. We have these for the hands, body, and head. Right now, front-facing profiles are all selected, and you can see the preview results here. Let's go up to our scene manager now and select a side-facing character. We're going to choose the side profiles for both body and hand, and then preview once more. You can see the modified results here, where one palm will be facing towards us and the other one facing the other direction. There are a number of different offset settings that you can use to modify the result of your capture in Cartoon Animator. Ground offset basically modifies the character's position relative to the simulated ground from the mocap. If you have foot contact enabled, your character will begin to crouch as you move it downward. If we release the foot contact, you can move it freely without any regard for the simulated ground plane. Let's enable foot contact one more time and see the difference. If you want to modify your character's natural default pose, you can do that as well using the neck, torso, and hip rotation sliders. You can give your character an entirely different personality by adjusting these. By combining hip, neck, and torso rotation, you can give your character an entirely different personality by adjusting their default poses. Posture can really make a difference when it comes to making your character more sluggish or energetic. One common problem with mocap is that sometimes it requires movements that cover long distances, which means that in Cartoon Animator, your character may simply run off the screen. For example, if we preview this run, it's only a matter of time before we need to say goodbye to our alien as he leaves the scene. To solve this issue, you can use the camera track setting. You'll see once it's enabled that the camera will track our character's movement throughout the scene. Even if your mocap actor rotates, your on-screen character will continue moving in the same direction, which is often beneficial for 2D mocap solutions. Similarly, we also have position lock. If we have a motion but we want our character to remain stationary, then we need to enable position lock. This ensures that our character in Cartoon Animator 4 will remain in place, despite the actions of our actor in Perception Neuron. You can enable unlock height if you want actions like jumps or bounces to transfer to your on-screen character. This is normally a good idea in order to get more natural up and down movement. Another cool feature with the mocap plugin is anti-sliding for both your character's hands and feet. You can see here that our on-screen character's feet are sliding slightly, despite our mocap actor having a solid footing. As we gradually slide the foot threshold parameter to a higher value, you'll see the result becoming better and better. If you want to apply an absolute lock onto the feet, you can do so as well, as you can see here. Keep in mind that locking the feet will create a different result, as they will remain grounded. If your mocap actor raises their feet, it will simply stretch the limbs of your on-screen character. You can do the same thing for the hands as well with the hand threshold. Note that the hands will essentially be locked at the wrist area, so there may still be some movement in the fingers. However, the palm will remain stationary. One cool thing you can do with motion capture is mask certain parts of the body out in order to combine your captured motions with motion clips from your motion library. Here we see our alien doing some kung fu, and if we click on both the legs to mask them out, you'll see he continues with the hand motions, but the legs will remain stationary. Let's go ahead and reset the masking and then apply a motion from our content manager. In this case, we're choosing a simple dance. Next, let's expand the timeline a bit and shorten our project length to play back on a loop. You can easily adjust the project length by clicking on that little red triangle on the timeline and dragging it to whatever frame you want your project to end at. And make sure playback is looping. From there, we can reconnect our mocap and you'll see that it plays over the motion clip. However, if we mask out the legs now, the motion that you see on the character will retain the original clip motion for the legs and combine it with the captured motion for the upper body. So as you can see, body mocap with Cartoon Animator is fast and easy to set up, and there are lots of cool and creative ways that you can customize your mocap as well. Thanks for watching, everyone. Make sure to check out our forums over at forum.reillusion.com, and I hope to see you in the next video.